So, Ray, can you explain what a projection is from a higher dimension to a lower dimension? Because when we think of projecting something from 3D to a shadow in 2D, we think of we need light behind it. So, when you're projecting E8 from 8 dimensions to 4D, are you using light? Because there is no light really in 8D, right? Can you, it's confusing.
Yes, what is confusing is that you are using light to make a physical projection of a shadow, but geometrical, what is important is the light ray, which is in fact the line of projection. So, for example, if we project from 3D to 2D, so this is your two-dimensional plane, and you project from 3D. So, to see what you can project, you just take points. So here you have a point, for example, a point in 3D, which is not in the plane, and it will be projected here, like that, in the plane. Okay. Now we can have another point here, which is on the same line, perpendicular to the plane, because there is a direction of projection which is here perpendicular to the plane of projection, to the projected space. And if the second point is on the same lines as the first, it gives to the same projection. So that's why projection can lose some information in this case.
Wait, so are you saying that when you project something from a higher dimension, then different points on the higher dimensional object become one point when it's on the plane?
Yes, they can if they are on the same ray, on the same line. And you can see this easily with coordinate because this point, for example, if you say that your plane is x, y, and the perpendicular line is z, then here they are on x equals 1. So this point, the coordinate is 1 for x, 0 for y, and 1 for z. This other point is 1, 0, but 2 for z. When you project these two points, you just take the first coordinate. In fact, the operation of projection is just forgetting some coordinates. So the projection is the same. And these are the coordinates of the projected point in this plane. Now I will show you how you project E8 to a quasicrystal, so E8 to 4D. But I cannot draw 8 dimension and 4 dimension, so I will again draw projection to a plane. So you can say that this is one of the plane in the 4-dimensional quasicrystal. And I see one perpendicular direction, which is one of the direction of the four perpendicular direction. So then, E8 is a lattice, is a crystal, and is a kind of cubic lattice. In fact, it's a little more complex because in reality, this is a Gauss polytope, but it's the same if I draw a cube here to understand. So this is the cell of the lattice. In fact, this is Z8, not E8, but everything is similar. And this is a grid, because a lattice, this is one singular cell which is repeated itself many times. What is important is the unit cell, and I have an angle here, because I show you that if I have several points on the same lines, oops, my marker. Just before, several points on the same line, they are projected to the same point. This is not interesting for the quasicrystal. So if you want that the point of the lattice are not on the same line, I just have to take an angle between the lattice and the plane of projection. Then every point will be projected to a different point. In fact, if you take the whole lattice, infinite lattice, it will be projected to an infinite number of points in this plane. That's why, to make a quasicrystal, we don't take an infinite lattice, we cut it. So we take a slice of this lattice, and it's easy to see what is the height of the slice. So the height of the slice is the height in the direction which is perpendicular to the projection plane, and this height should be taken so you have the two extremal points of the cube. So this is this point and this point. It will give the height, and then from this height I will take here a three-dimensional slice. So it will define two points. So this point is in this plane, and this point is in this plane. And everything, every point from my lattice, my cubic lattice, which are between these two planes, will be projected to point here in this plane, and they will project to a quasicrystal. So this is a good illustration. What happens is that in reality, instead of this direction, so the height of the window, of the cut window, instead of being one-dimensional here, because here I'm projecting from 3D to 2D, so I lost one dimension, which is the dimension of the cut window. In the E8 Elzer-Sloan quasicrystal, I project from 8 to 4. So in fact, I have four perpendicular directions of my cut window. I represented only one, but I have four, so this is more complicated. And also here, instead of having a plane, I have also a four-dimensional space, which is named the physical space. And this one, where is the cut window, is the perpendicular space. And then, so the operation is just to rotate first, to rotate your lattice compared to the plane of projection, to only select the point which are in the cut window in the perpendicular space, and to project them to the physical space. And this is very easy to do with the coordinate. In fact, I have eight-dimensional coordinate of my lattice. For example, it could be 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Watch, eight coordinates. And I make this rotation. To make the rotation, I just take the coordinate 2 by 2, and I transform them into Dirichlet integer by multiplying by 1, 5, 1, 5, 1, 5, 1, 5. And then, this coordinate will become 1 plus 5, for example. So I generate with 5 then, with the Dirichlet integer, an 8 by 8 matrix. 8, so it's 8 by 8, which I multiply by this vector, this eight-dimensional vector. And then I get eight-dimensional rotated coordinate, which are like 1 plus 5, 1 minus 5, 0, 0, something like that. And to do the projection, I just keep the first four coordinates, which will be the coordinate of the projection. But I need also the four other coordinates, because the four other coordinates are the coordinate inside of the cut window, inside of the space of the cut window. And in fact, to know if I am inside of the cut window or not, I just have to compute the norm of this vector. So, and if this norm is smaller than the height of my cut window, then I am inside of the cut window and I keep the point. If my norm here of this part is bigger than the height of the cut window, for example for this point, I am outside of the cut window, therefore I don't use the projection of this point inside of the quasicrystal. So this is just the algorithm to generate a quasicrystal from E8 to 4D, or from D6 to 3D, which is named the Cramer D6 quasicrystal, or from Z5 to 2D, which is a Penrose styling, or another, which is a Amann tiling from Z6 to 3D. So with the same method, and also from 2D to 1D, you get the Fibonacci chain. So you can get five different quasicrystals with golden ratio. And why we have the golden ratio, this is because it's in the matrix. And this is because we need this rotation to be sure that the distance, the edge, the length of the edge when they will be projected will be 1 and phi, the length. So, and the length, because naturally the length in the crystal are all the same, 1 for example, or 2, but when they are projected they are reduced, and if we choose the right angle they will be reduced to only 2 different lengths, 1 and phi. And this is the case where the quasicrystal is very interesting and has self-similarity properties and five-fold symmetry. And then we get icosahedral quasicrystal like our QSN. So there is some choice for this angle, which is defined inside of the choice of the rotation matrix. But in fact, the rotation matrix which is working is just involving 1 and phi, and is just corresponding to use an isomorphism between the coordinate in the 8-dimensional space as integer and the coordinate in the 4-dimensional space as Dirichlet integer.
That's it?
Yes, another question?
No.
No? Oh, so good. Thank
you. How do I name this video?
How to make a quasicrystal by cut and project method.
But specifically from E8 to 4D?
From E8 to 4D, but it works also for some other quasicrystal. Cramer, Amann, and Penrose, and Fibonacci.
Thank you, Ray.
So, Elser Sloan, Cramer, Amann, Penrose, and Fibonacci. These five quasicrystals share the most interesting one.